Let's talk about car-gear ratios. In this video, we'll be going over how to calculate the number of revolutions the wheels will turn for a given engine RPM, what the torque multiplication will be after going through the driveline, and what force will reach the outside edge of the wheels. Now, in most cars, there is an engine that supplies torque and RPMs into the system. This is marked all the way to the left as two pistons. A transmission that is marked with a purple box around it, which consists of multiple gears that can be changed depending on the speed of the vehicle. This changes torque and RPMs reaching the wheels. Once you get going at higher speeds, you don't need as much torque to keep going, so the transmission switches to a higher gear with a larger sequential gear number. This higher gear has a smaller gear ratio, so there is less torque at higher RPMs reaching the wheels at a higher gear. Finally, there is an axle, which has a fixed gear ratio, also known as an axle ratio. This turns RPMs and lower torque at the input into lower RPMs at higher torque at the output, or in this case, the wheels. In this example, we'll be using my car. So I've listed out the gear ratios of the transmission and axle for my vehicle. We need to collect the engine RPMs and speed at the desired gear, in this case, first gear, find out how many times the wheels will spin around. We will use an engine RPM of 2400 RPMs at 20 miles per hour in first gear. Now we need to find the radius of the wheels. As you can see from this picture, it is 15 inches. Sorry to those who think in metric, however, the logic to solve this problem should still apply. So now let's list out all of our divins, and we will first solve for the theoretical wheel rotations per minute. Need to find the wheel circumference in miles. This can be done by taking 2 pi times the wheel radius times the conversion of inches to miles. The next step is to find how many miles per minute the car is traveling. This can be completed by converting the speed in miles per hour to miles per minute. We can take the miles per hour speed and divide by 60 minutes to get the miles per minute. Finally, we can take the miles per minute and divide by the tire circumference in miles to get the theoretical wheel revolutions per minute. The theoretical RPMs is 224 RPMs. Recall that for every one revolution of the driven gear, the driver gear, or where the torque and motion is coming from, rotates the number of times listed in the gear ratio. So now let's solve for the experimental wheel RPMs. We can take the engine RPMs and divide by the transmission gear ratio, and then divide by the axle ratio. We get about 226 wheel RPMs for our experimental value. Now let's calculate how much torque is reaching the wheels. Recall for the gear trains, we can multiply the gear ratios together to get equivalent gear ratio. We can take the input torque and multiply it times the transmission gear ratio and the axle ratio. We get that with an input torque of 100 foot-pounds, we get around 10 times the torque, or about 1,059 foot-pounds at the wheels. This is assuming 100% driveline efficiency. Now to finish off the video, let's take the output torque and divide it by the wheel radius to get how much force is applied to the ground by the wheels. In this case, the wheels are applying a force of 847.5 pounds. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Hopefully I earned a like, share, or subscription. If you like this video, you may also enjoy one of these videos.